it stirs here.
This program is rated 13, recommended for family viewing.
About six shops downtown have already decorated themselves as far as Christmas is concerned. I was perplexed, and then until I realized that, you know what, we just have 2 months, actually not even 2 months, 1 month and a couple of weeks until we start singing jingle bells, jingle bells. It is 31st of October, and that means we are waving this month goodbye. Just after this, tomorrow we shall be ushering in a new month, and I definitely hope that no matter what you have gone through this year, you have something good to celebrate later on in December. And of course, I remember that we shall be looking forward to celebrating 1st December, which will be World AIDS Day. And in November, we shall be talking about AIDS and everything to do with fighting this HIV virus. Now, moving away from that, of course, I would like to say good morning to you and good morning to everyone that is just tuned in right about now to catch the best of the 2 hours infotainment show, Urban Today. And remember that we are always live on Facebook, which is Urban Television, and Twitter. It is at Urban TV Uganda. Feel free to get in touch with us. And being a throwback today, we would like to get some memories from you. What are you throwing back? If you head over to our Twitter this morning, we were throwing back to our Mbogo challenge. If you remember this one, yes, just head over there, and in case you didn't catch it, you'll definitely find it on our Urban Television Twitter handle. Now, of course, I do have Tina Fierce, and we shall be holding it down, just the two of us. We have decided to throw back to those days when relationships were just about two people. Right now it's about like three people, four
triangular
people.
Triangular, hexagonal.
Octagon, so we don't understand what's going on. But anyway, what's happening?
On the low. I mean, it's a beautiful day. It's the last day of October. I have to say, it's been quite an October for me.
Yeah, so, man. Yeah.
But it's ended. Christmas is knocking. Burundi. We're calling Deo Kachiguno.
Ochitegeda.
But
It's okay. It's all right.
That is one big party.
Hey.
Imagine that being the advice someone gives you in the morning.
But it's okay. By the way, it's okay. Life is short. Let me tell you, Tina. Life is very short. Today you'll wake up. Tomorrow you'll not wake up. It is that short that you'll sleep and then you'll not wake up.
No, you'll sleep and wake up when you're not sleeping.
You get. So it's that confusing. We also don't understand the real road to life. That is one.
But it's a throwback, you know. Mm. It's a throwback Thursday. I think it is true. Let us throw back to the times when relationships were just two people.
Two people.
The dynamics of relationships these days. Whoa, hey! I was saying to someone the other day, I heard something that perturbed me.
Mm.
Now, I've always had swinger couples, like swingers. Mm-hmm. Like, they are married,
mm-hmm.
but they can have...
other people?
Yes.
In the relationship?
Yes, and okay. at the same time together with them.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
So I met this guy. We used to know each other back in the day. In high school, he was laid back, and he tells me, I'm a swinger. I was like... Swiwa? Like, seriously, a swiwa? Like, Jesus is the Lord. And he's like, yeah, you know, T, marriages are getting harder, and we don't want to keep breaking down the institution of marriage. I'm like, okay, so how do you save that institution? And then he boldly tells me, he's like, you introduce new spices into the marriage. I'm like, oh, do you introduce them individually or at the same time? He's like, well, for us, given we are swingers, it is at the same time. I'm like...
Now that we are talking about marriages, what we are going to do is very simple. We're going to go in for a very small break. When we do get back, an expert will be joining us to give us how it was back in the days regarding marriages and relationships. Now, getting into, of course, what we've been talking about this morning, we do have Pac Mother. She was there in those days of 70s. You see, we had decided
to do... old people on your...
I have old and older.
Yeah, Mzenze Bananga, legendary. Aromu Nakuza, Kunta Kinte, Aromu Nakuza, I missed that one. That movie, remember? Auntie Ndimukadi, I was around, so...
It's okay. Kimi. At the end of the day, it's old wine, fine wine, you know, old bottles.
In those days.
High five.
We are throwing back to old relationships. Much kola nga mutemu.
Banange omukwano gwatu tanga. Banaye nga senga ja Justina kugamba. Na scouti nze nenkula biloru vubukoru. Go golf. Siru sezi. Siru love nigga. Siru semye kozo. Siru weya yu.
Na kufuni. Na kufuni.
I've been liaising with someone out there talking about the beauty of how things were done. The beauty was you didn't have to worry so much because community was always there. It always had your
back. It had your back. Every time.
You didn't really have to worry
for your kids, when they
for the relationship. You didn't have to worry.
Nga ababera na bakumanyi bamanyi nti ono ye aine wafe mwe alimu olwenzi ne bamufunia kagalo nga kakakamu
ndako mu ndako bali babanda bakubya tubate mu byadda toko salinyali angezo wa 2000 Choose, because it's a Willis.
Because
it's a Willis.
Katingoni.
Willis.
Ati, because it's a
Willis. Willis, in your dimuru masoko mudeko. We cannot add that pain now.
Okay, but James.
So, ngaba mani. So, ngaba did a hot. Never jiteka ko cold. So you sizzle.
Wasanga kana kakalinga kani ani ani reketango mnyongo gudem matai kampala gomani.
Hamkazwa ngera watali yokatumuleke.
Gundio no.
Gundio
no ya ni ono.
Ani o yobo bato mduki dali nyango manyata mireka.
Manyata mire. Disanja luzinda.
Aha. Tuleke na awe.
We need no aji.
You know what? What is
so, like I was saying, I was telling you, Babu, that I'm trying to get a relationship. I've been to Vietnam, I remember them called a research. Never to come, but never work out to get into those days. Singers used to go under the bed. When you, I want to know if it is true.
It is not true.
He didn't just go there.
No, he
was just asking.
But he's entitled to.
I want to know.
The first time I had Buganda culture and the things that they used to do back way.
The singer would go under the bed. On then as you perform your commercialized agriculture,
on your
when you're not
night.
Doing it well, he comes out and he's like, "Wait, you me vow, you're just joking."
Let me show you.
You want
to try my Chinese and Kung
Fu?
Actually, it wasn't everywhere in Africa. There was that adage of someone older needs to show someone young how to do it. Even now, there are those ones who actually practice it.
Okay.
Where even the bride has to first sleep with the father-in-law. Yeah.
We still have them now
in Africa.
Wait,
Kinda ko throw back at me for say current situation.
Zoko veo. Okay. I know, right?
Yeah, it happens. It's still happening.
Wait, so I'm the bride, and I get to sleep with the father.
Actually,
with the father of the groom.
Yes.
Wasn't that part of Kahunde's escapades?
It caused something.
Did she mention it? You remember when
we had
Diana Kahunde here? I think she mentioned something like that.
She did.
Yeah, when she was staying at the father-in-law's place. I don't know. I'm not really remembering.
Kati wano mu Buganda.
But yo, do you know what it means to know that my dad banged my wife?
Okay. He grew up looking for. It's like where the traditions, a marriage night. Hold on, that isn't even the worst. On a marriage night, the girl comes out and she's pure, damn naked. For everyone to touch and appreciate her body.
Exactly, and then the white sheets and all of that.
And she has to just be naked and oiled up and walk around naked serving guys. But that is their culture. It's their tradition.
throwback.
I don't want to go back to them days. You know what? I thought it is messed up now. I'll stick with the current situation. Thank you.
Now, talking about seeing the current situation, there's something that, you know, me and my friends were discussing earlier. Everyone said, you know what, since I have two, you know, intellectuals on the show, I have two educated ladies, they are learned, they are experienced, they are focused, they have done this thing, they can speak English, and, you know, even Trump will go on, you know, his Twitter and say that is fake news.
Fake news, just fake
so,
news.
So, you know, when you're preparing food and you put a lot of salt, what do you say when you're testing it? The food is what?
Salty.
Salty.
Salty,
yes. Onion, bitch, corn. What do you say? Onion. Onion.
Don't think too hard.
It's musky, because onions are musky. They have a musky scent. So it's musky.
Mm. What if, okay, what if you've dropped mascara there by mistake? What do you say?
Musky.
Wait, guys. Why would you be dropping mascara in
your
onion soup?
Yes.
Is it pick and play?
Yes. Rawano, let's see.
Uganda government, where are you?
Yeah, where are you? Where are you? By the way, I read a meme yesterday and someone was saying. Yeah.
So, Ogamet is musky?
Musky. Okakute. Someone was saying.
This tea
no.
is musky. Okay, what if there's a lot of sugar?
Sugary.
I'm going to go
the original owner of the where are you is God. God comes to the Garden of Eden and says, Adam, where are you?
Let us differentiate between where are you with
no,
where are you.
Yagamba, where are you?
God, boy, Yagamba.
Kamera Genesis.
Oh, yeah, Yakoze Mime has a special place in hell. Toys are quick dog, no limbi Yakatonda, because you want to just make people funny.
Where are you?
Talking about government in our starting news, of course, we are letting you know what is coming through from the government side. Now, apparently, government okays new designs for the new parliamentary chambers. This is a conversation that has been going on, and here are the details. The Solicitor General has approved the contract for the Parliamentary Commission to alter construction designs for its new chambers. The altered design will increase the number of floors on the new parliamentary chambers from 8 to 9 to accommodate an extra 100 seats for legislators and Alta Modern Museum. Now, the cleared contract by the SG is government-funded project. The contract was signed by the Clerk to Parliament representing Parliamentary Commission and Rocco Construction Limited, who won the contract for constructing the newly parliamentary chambers. Now, Sentongo and Partners, a private firm, contracted to oversee the construction project, while the Ministry of Works and Transport is the overall supervisor. The new development means that on top of the museum, 100 more seats will be added to the 500 seats that will be an inspection and had been planned for office accommodation for legislators. When contacted, that is Parliamentary Director Commissions and Public Affairs, Helen Kawesa confirmed the development, urging that it means more seats for legislators and bigger space for a museum.
First of all, what I'm going to say, I'm going to use the same exact words, but the same exact words, but I'm going to flip them. So what we need is way, way lesser chairs, seats, huge space for a museum to remind us of all the dimwits that were in here.
That's it. I think I'm also looking
less
at it from that angle.
Museum.
If for the museum, it makes sense. Yeah. It makes sense. I mean, we need it.
No.
But the seats, clearly, we already have an issue of absenteeism right about now.
Absenteeism is okay. We still have a problem of way too many parliamentarians who we don't even know.
No. What are they doing? It's one thing.
Who has been your member of parliament for the past 3 terms?
But when it comes to our country, I don't know why they do the wrong things the right way.
And they do it to
why are they so addicted to doing the wrong things the right
way? Can't
we just know that we are, it's like churches. You build big churches, and the people who are building the big churches are these poor peasants who keep going to these churches.
And then
yet,
I keep asking,
after
wait,
they attend service, they go back to their miserable lives
and come back
no
and say,
millage,
God is good.
And then you come back and tell the guys, God is good.
First
why
wait,
do you expect a Ugandan to do? Why wouldn't they hack their fellow friends?
No, first let me tell you, I read a quote and it made so much sense in the same light she's saying. She said, only in Africa do you get a vivid picture that God is not there. You know why? Because in Africa, one thing we have in plenty is religion, faith, and belief.
But even the Bible says
it. Every morning, you know,
give Caesar what belongs to Caesar. You're contributing to the house of the Lord. It's okay. How they use the money is not your problem. You have done your part.
So is our problem. We are way out of that era of how they use the money is not my problem. It is my problem.
Well, according to according
I make the contribution.
No, listen, because the reason I am coming to your church, I am looking for deliverance. I am going to touch fervently. I am going to come there on a daily. I will give offertory. So hell yeah. It is my business what you use my tight money for. Because it's a transaction.
According to the religious teachings.
It's a transaction between me and my interpreter.
Yeah.
That is why in the Bible there is no part that says there should be accountability of your money.
No, we don't have to really go by the Bible. At some point, we are human first.
We have to use
Then we are Bible second. Use a bit of your brain because I mean, it is on your head. It is on your neck.
Religiously, it doesn't work like that, whether you want it or not. God is not going to sit down and say, okay, this happened.
Let me ask a very, very simple question. Religiously, that's how it is.
Yes,
right?
That's how it is.
According to who?
Ethically, it might be wrong.
According to the Bible teachings. So according to the Bible teachings.
Give Caesar what belongs to Caesar.
Okay, let him shoot his foot.
I mean,
it was a canon. It came from the Torah. But then there were like 1,001 books that were decided on. Then they say, okay, but my favorite is King Solomon.
So what is your problem here? The fact that people use their money and build churches?
No. We are trying to show you that do not rely on religion.
Yeah.
Religion was put together by a bunch of people who knew what they wanted to
do. I think that is the wrong idea.
Use your logic.
It is a conversation I'm not going to be part of. Let me get into more strategies.
Hold on.
What is happening at Makere? I'm not going to be part of religiousness here on the show. No, I will not go there. What is going to happen is very simple. That dictatorship is okay. It is allowed in
Uganda. It is not okay. No, it is not okay.
Down at Makere University, they have come out of course to suspend 9 students and warned 26. Now, this is of course coming in as far as, you know, the latest is happening down at Makere University. Now, Makere University has suspended 9 students and warned 26 of them for allegedly destroying a property during the ongoing unrest at the institution. The university's management published the names of those suspended and warned in a communication on its website and social media accounts. This is partly over what was written on the account. Management has taken disciplinary action on students who have destroyed university property, injured fellow students, and property for businesses operating outside. The involved students have been suspended and others warned. The statement on the university's official Twitter handle read, suspended students include Frank Bwambale, pursuing bachelor's degree of journalism and communication, Maurice Sasirabo, that is of course pursuing a bachelor's degree in industry and organization psychology, Rogers Mbajo, as well as, you know, Derek Ojambo, and not forgetting of course a couple of others right there. Those are the names of some of the students that were suspended after of course the talks with, you know, the school representatives and the administration went into vain.
And they're being suspended for ruining infrastructure and indiscipline. Okay, indiscipline
students
should be punished. However, let everyone, like how you flip the coin, you punish the head and you punish the tail. You cannot just punish the tail by itself and leave the head. Because at the end of the day, the tail is going to come back and smite. Isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Kind of, but you see, here's what I'm going to say about this whole Makere situation. Whether management wants to accept it or not, every time these kids strike, it's like they're whistleblowing.
Yeah.
And the more they whistleblow, the more we actually understand that whoever is at the top is the problem. They are eating and eating and eating. But you see, like the good book says, not the Bible anymore. Shakespeare said it somewhere, I think. Like the book, good book says, what goes around does come around. And at the end of some times and some days, so whether they suspend these students, whether they expel them,
the problem will remain.
The problem is still going to remain.
Yeah.
And this is what they say. The higher the monkey goes, the more it exposes its behind. This is Makere management going up and exposing its behind. So,
Two things to note for me. When I was interacting with a couple of students, they came up to say that, you know, striking at Makerere University
is sometimes a culture.
Yeah, it may not be just because of a reason, but it's a culture. It's a culture. It's something that has to happen within a semester. So they feel like if it doesn't happen, something is going wrong.
Something wrong.
That is one. Two, members of parliament have come out to ask, you know, the vice chancellor, who's of course not the acting one, but the previous one, that is Barnabas, to actually step down. What do you make of these two situations?
They're asking him to step down.
Yeah.
Now, you say that there's a lot of stupidity going on here.
They're asking Professor Nawangwe to step down.
Number one, the guild only lasts a year. It does not make any sense because in a year, you have set a few things that you're going to follow by. And you cannot see them through because when the year elapses, another term comes in. Okay? Now, this 15%, first of all. Okay, maybe the guild of last year accepted to it. But what were the circumstances surrounding it? Yeah, but what were the circumstances surrounding it? Twainza kudida mwana we Makerere. Yeta gobu kade butano okumala kwa semester. Arinaka kade kamu. Tushon tana mumarayo. Nori yoko muteka kwa sente kumeza. You're swinging a bribe in front of them and then you want them to pass the 15%. Because why? Because when the year ends, they will not be accountable to it anymore. Someone else is going to inherit that problem.
True.
So right
so
now
I
this
think
guild
it was
has
an inherited problem.
Right now this guild has inherited that problem of 15%, but then they woke up and they're like, damn, this thing is so big. Turino kugura handouts. Handouts semi-stock manako etagemi almost 600,000. Turino kudia. Tamo kumanako semi-stock manako wetaga at least 500,000. Not even being greedy, not even spending outside of it. Weta go kusasura tuition. Weta go Olabo mwana madijiza Makerere, transcript ya kukaba. The only guys who were lucky to get the transcripts on time were the ones that were graduating, I think back in 2007.
Ago. No, it was like about two years ago.
2007. Wow. That was when the rule of the transcript had passed. Like, guys were on the dot.
So,
when
were graduating, and they
got yes, yes. Omwana wa medicine, amado graduating. Na tulo mwaka mulambanga adinze transcript ye. Chokabu ogendo kusawa omudimu, bakugamba, transcripted. Why are we treating these children so badly, and you don't want them to stand up for their rights? Like, which kind of word are we aiming for?
It's very sad what is happening at the institution right there. And of course, every day we get to find out different news that comes out. But of course, the moment we do that, we always make sure to keep informed. Now, getting into our shout outs this morning. But now, shout out to Yang again, our president of Guinea-Bissau. Amunda Bideko, Mugambe Mutumide. Hey, Munang, President Jose Maria Vaz. Now, apparently, what is going down is very funny. Guinea-Bissau President Jose Maria, that's of course Vaz, named a new prime minister on Tuesday, but his sacked predecessor refused to step down, intensifying a bitter power struggle between Vaz and the ruling party weeks ahead of the presidential election. Vaz, who's ruling again in November, who's running again in November, that is of course the 24th poll, dissolved the government, let saying the political situation was undermining the normal functioning of state institutions in West African country. It has suffered repeated bouts of instability since it became independent from Portugal in 1974, including 9 coups or attempted coups and a siege in cocaine trafficking from South America that has been linked to senior military officials. The country has been largely peaceful since Vaz came into power in 2014 election that followed a coup 2 years earlier, but he has repeatedly clashed over the balance of power in the semi-presidential system with a string of prime ministers. Just imagine our own president.
One does never cease to amaze. Like, he comes in and is like,
Ruhakana is like,
No, my friend.
I'm not going anywhere.
I go away. Hey. Do your duties.
You go.
But this is only in Africa. Like, we do not respect hierarchy. But then also, usually what kills us is the greed. But anyway, I was speaking to a friend of mine and they asked me, Ime, do you know what it means when you're in power? Like, you get into big car, you're drunk with the power.
Yes.
You get into this big car, you do not know how the fuel got into the big car, you don't even know how the vehicle is moving, but it's moving. But You
eat.
Basically, you wali traffic jam gweta kukwato. Jalwiri. Ngo ita mbalaru, ita mbakusa sura. Ngo gendo odie metoma ina beya yo.
Ngo gamba njagara iPhone 11.
Ngeja. Basically, the power gets to you and you do not
you
know.
You get drunk in power.
You can't let it go. Like you don't even know how to survive without
how
that power.
How to be no more.
Now, odirono musajyo mugambe baby. Where are you?
Exit.
Akoreleje.
Ajagamba no musajyo nasaga. Fabatere mbundu.
Yeah. Fabagenda musiko. Where am I going?
Anywho, still speaking of people with power and in places of power who love power and won't let power go.
In you just way. Have to.
I mean, it rhymes. It rhymes. I'm sending shout outs to none other than my president. Someone said, why do I always say my president sarcastically? I don't. I'm sending shout outs to my president. Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. And now, President Yoweri Museveni has highly appreciated the use of denatured ethanol fuel stoves, saying the effort goes a long way in supporting the government's bid to curtail and reduce the challenges the country faces as regards to deforestation, especially in northern Uganda. Now, the president made the remarks during a meeting with a delegation from Acholi sub-region-based Bakona Agro Processors Limited, who called on him at State House in Tebe. The Archbishop of Gulu Archdiocese, the Most Reverend John Baptist Odama, led the delegation. Our Finance and Economic Minister, Mr. Matia Kasaija, attended the meeting. I thank the owners of Bukona Agro Processing Factory for their innovation. On top of churning out food, the factory also produces ethanol, which generates a strong blue-colored flame from processing the product. The processed cassava will not only attract a good market, but also as a fuel-generating product will contribute to the protection of the environment. That is what he said. Mm-hmm. I mean, which is good. I'm all for conservation, always.
Isn't always. This a campaign? Like, where do you draw a line between a campaign and actually?
I don't know what. No, I think it may have time to get too sentimental.
No, it's okay.
No, listen.
I'm asking.
And I think
it's a question.
Unfair. It's unfair for the ruling party right now that anything that the ruling party does at the moment is going to be looked at as a plight to win votes.
But you also have the right to say it's not a campaign.
This has nothing to do with winning votes with campaigning.
Exactly. You forget that the
same government. It's just about the environment.
The same government and ruling party still had things they had set out to do even before their elections. Now, some of them may have come much later. Some of them may have come earlier. They still had a plan. And I remember a couple of years back, the last budget reading, that made sense to me anyway. When they told us, it's like, we're going to go into infrastructure most. We're going to do industrialization. Now, they're giving you the industries that they talked about then. And still, as Ugandans, we still have the nerve to be like,
So is this where I come in and say, hey, hooray. Yeah, okay, it's very good.
No, this
but
is
all
where you
say,
come in with logic and just say,
it's okay.
That's a good thing.
It's okay. Let's say, I cannot say it's a good thing because that is your school of thought, but I also have my own school of thought. My school of thought, it's a very good move. However, in northern Uganda, power generation, have you been there? Do you know how hot it is there? I would think the first thing we pay attention to is the solar. We can do the solar. We can harvest the solar and it can do this power.
That is the thing you don't understand. They are shooting two birds
with one stone.
You're looking at
solar. The cassava. So I look at the cassava.
They're doing the biodegradable gas. So it's a win-win.
It's a win-win. Okay, and on that note, I am going with Tina. Amazing. Beautiful.
Let's get into more shout-outs.
And by the way, I was just being sarcastic.
Okay.
The Uganda Civil Aviation Authority has been crowned winner of the Going Global Award 2019 after it was recognized by the International Trade Council as the Government Agency of the Year in Aviation. This award comes a month after the International Civil Aviation Organization recognized Uganda with the ICAO Council President Certificate for efforts in resolving aviation security deficiencies. At the ICAO Assembly in Montreal, Canada on September 24, 2019. UCAA publicist Mr. Vianney Lugia says the award is in recognition of the customer care, infrastructure improvement, trading of staff and contribution towards supporting tourism and agriculture exports facilitated through Entebbe International Airport.
All right,
well,
there you have it.
Want something.
Of course, something coming in from the shout-outs. We're going for a very quick break, but when we do get back, we'll take a quick look at what is making headlines as far as the Press Digest is concerned.